We're not going back to the same economy. We're recovering, but to a different economy. And it'll be one that is more leveraged to technology. And I worry that that is going to make it even more difficult than it was for many workers.
In Silicon Valley, and my friends who work in technology know that what we did to the manufacturing workers, we are now going to do to the retail workers, the call center workers, the fast food workers, the truck drivers, and then even bookkeepers, accountants, insurance agents, lawyers, and on through the economy. So what happened to the manufacturing workers is a very clear sign of what's going to happen to these other workers moving forward. And I talked a little bit about retail.
Welcome to the Crypto Teacher. And guys, you know, I come back with that video just to make you think. And guys, an executive order was signed yesterday called Promoting the Use of Trustworthy Artificial Intelligence in the Federal Government. Now, basically, this was a piggyback off the February the 11th, 2019, Maintaining American Leadership in Artificial Intelligence. The executive order that was signed yesterday states the purpose of artificial intelligence promises to drive the growth of the United States economy and improve the quality of life for all Americans. Now, just like I stated, this executive order was put in place February the 11th, 2019, around the same time the CARES Act bill had started. Remember, they changed the name to the CARES Act. That bill was already going through place in 2019. They just gutted it out and renamed it. But also going forward, it states that executive departments and agencies have recognized the power of AI to improve their operations, processes, procedures, meet strategic goals, reduce costs, enhance oversight of the use of taxpayer funds, increase efficiency and mission effectiveness, improve quality of service, improve safety, train workforces, and support the decision-making by the federal workforce, among other positive developments. Now, given the broad capabilities of AI, nearly every agency and those served by those agencies can benefit from the appropriate use of AI. Now, I'm going to drop further down to get to the important part. Lawful and respectful of our nation's values, agencies shall design, develop, and acquire and use AI in a manner that exhibits due respect for our nation's values and is consistent with the Constitution and all other applicable laws and policies, including those addressing privacy, civil rights, and civil liberties. So guys, the way I'm reading this is basically they're going to build a system. They're going to build AI behind the scenes that are going to be making decisions along with the actual federal government on all policies and eventually replacing, of course, the politicians and all the workers. Well, all this will be done by AI. Now, of course, last year, a survey was done over in Europe and other parts of the country, is that would they want people making decisions or would they have AI? Now, of course, 30% of them said AI. In other countries, it was higher than that. Now, what do you have going on right now? You have the C word. We know the New World Order creates the problem. Wait for the reaction. Come in with the solution. Now, you have all these people out of work, and what are your politicians doing? They're stalling out when they could have easily came together and got it done. Remember, the CARES Act was voted 29-0. Why didn't they have any issues with doing that? They didn't have any issues with voting it in because they had to get people off the workforce in order to bring in this fourth industrial revolution. So, guys, AI, what I talk about all the time, and I know y'all get upset with me. Why is he always talking about this? Now you see the cryptos moving in. You see the AI moving in. Now we're going to have drones flying over your head. It's all coming, for therefore the powers that be have all the control. We know that the IMF is eventually going to have all the control with Bretton Woods 2.0 with the SDRs, where they can push liquidity straight to the people. Now let's get further into the executive order. responsible and traceable agencies shall ensure the human roles and responsibilities are clearly defined, understood, appropriately assigned for the design, development, acquisition, and use of AI. Agencies shall ensure that AI is used in a manner consistent with these principles and the purposes for which each use of AI is intended. The design, development, acquisition, and use of AI, as well as relevant inputs and outputs of particular AI applications, should be well documented and traceable and appropriate to the extent practicable. So guys, again, they are building and doing a test run to have AI be our government. So the federal workforce, also our politicians, will be replaced by artificial intelligence right along with us, guys. The powers that be want it all. And remember, I state that all the time. Politicians are nothing but puppets. That's it. They have no power, guys. We know this. I've been over it time and time again. We know that AI automation are built by us. But the only issue is that with these computers getting faster and smarter, of course, when we speak about Ben Gertzsil going over these machines being able to learn just like us, guess what? They're going to replace us. I just want to make sure you understand that. What they want to do is that they want us to work with these robots, this AI, so therefore they can feed off of us and therefore replace us. So it's no difference between when you have someone in the emerging markets coming into the United States or working overseas, how all the corporations went over there and they're paying those people 25 cents to a dollar. We're training them, so therefore they can replace us. Now, only thing they're doing is they're doing it with the robots. So now they don't even have to worry about paying the 25 cents or the dollar. Now they don't have to worry about paying anything. Remember, guys, what I teach you. Do not fall for the devil's tricks. Because the fact is, you have to be smart enough to learn the devil's devices. So therefore, you know how to step aside. Do not forget what Jerome Powell stated. We're not going back to this old economy. And a lot of people are going to get left behind. The same thing with Andrew Yang. Remember, he was a puppet to put out universal basic income, telling everybody they're not going to have a job unless they move to the new fourth industrial revolution. So guys, the New World Order puts it out there. They never lie to you. They just put it in plain sight where no one is looking. Y'all have a wonderful day.